Hi everyone, I wanted to give a brief update on where we are right now with the development of Munx VR, our software for building memory palaces in 3D and virtual reality. There have been a couple of unforeseen events in the last few months that have precipitated changes, so I wanted to explain what's going on. First of all, in December, Google announced that it would be shutting down Poly at the end of June 2021. Poly is Google's library of 3D models. Unfortunately, we use Poly for our library of mnemonics. So with Poly shutting down, it's kind of a big deal. We've had to plan an alternative. Currently, we just use Poly's API, and models are fetched remotely when a user opens a memory palace. What we're going to have to do is download as many of Poly's models as possible and create our own library native to the software. This will be a significant project, but it's absolutely essential so that our current users can keep all the mnemonics they've put into their memory palaces already. The second event is that recent software updates have caused the controllers to stop working with Valve and Oculus Quest headsets using Link. This appears to mean we're going to have to completely rebuild the laser pointer functionality so that it'll work across platforms. At first, we thought it would be a quick fix, just updating something, but it appears to be a much bigger issue. It's really frustrating because this is a major project and will take a lot of time and work, and all of it basically just to bring us back to where we were before. I personally have been using Munx with Quest via Link for over a year now, and now it doesn't work because of the controllers. While these changes are unforeseen and frustrating, they're just part of the process, and we know that these kinds of things arise. We're trying to take this opportunity to advance on a few other key changes to significantly improve the software. Over the last few years, we've had a lot of feedback from users, and we've done a lot of testing ourselves. There are a few big changes we're looking to make now. First, we want to improve the desktop version of the software in a number of key ways. A lot of people don't have VR headsets, or just want to be able to use the software in desktop mode, as well as experience it in VR. The desktop menu, however, always displays in the center of the screen, blocking the scene behind it. The reason for this is that the same menu has to work in both VR and desktop mode, and the software was originally built for VR. It's really annoying, and it means you have to constantly move around and away from the menu to do things within the virtual space. While it seems like this should also be something easy to change, it's much more complicated than it seems. One of the first changes we're going to work on is making this menu fixed along either the bottom or side of the screen in desktop mode. We've also had a lot of feedback from people that it's difficult to position mnemonics in space. Moving a mouse along a 2D surface to position objects in a 3D space is far from ideal. This is something else we're going to work on improving, making it easier to move, resize, and position mnemonics precisely in space. Along with this, we are working on a feature for guided modules that will automatically place mnemonics on instructor spots. Instructor spots encode the information for what mnemonics should go where in a pre-built memory palace. Since they are already positioned in space, we want to make it so that users can select the instructor spot, search for and select a mnemonic, and when that mnemonic is imported, it will show up automatically on the chosen spot. Along with this automatic placement feature, we want to add a suggested mnemonic feature. And this is really, really cool. Suggested mnemonics would be ideas for mnemonics that would show up on instructor spots that you could click on and automatically then search for that keyword. For example, let's say you're trying to remember a verbal ending in a language. Let's say it's just the letter A. Suggested mnemonics might be an alligator or an aardvark or an apple. Let's say you like the idea of an aardvark. You could then click on that word and the software would automatically search the libraries for images of aardvarks. You can then choose the one you want. I'm personally really excited about this suggested mnemonic feature because it strikes a good balance between having pre-chosen mnemonics, which I don't like, and having no suggestions at all, which can be really challenging for a lot of users. The reason I don't like pre-chosen mnemonics is that mnemonics are personal, and the more personal, the better. My mnemonics won't necessarily work for you. The act of considering and choosing a mnemonic is itself really important for memory storage. So this feature would allow users to pick mnemonics really quickly but still have to engage mentally with that decision process. You'll also still have the freedom to come up with whatever mnemonics work for you personally. One thing we're considering, but not sure if we'll be able to implement at this time, is integrating Tilt Brush. The same decision by Google to shut down Poly has also led to the company putting out its VR drawing and painting application as open source. If we can integrate this into Munx VR, it would allow users to draw and paint images in 3D in virtual reality within memory palaces themselves. In addition to all this, there are a number of architectural improvements we're working on, some of which wouldn't even be visible to users, and some of which are designed to allow us to create guided memory palaces faster and easier. Basically, we're working to improve as many aspects of user experience as possible. When it comes to building memory palaces in VR, the hardest and most time-consuming task is building the space and setting it up properly for the subject at hand. We're working to solve that problem by creating pre-built memory palaces. After that, the most challenging and time-consuming tasks are thinking of mnemonics and positioning them in space. We hope these changes will make Munx VR much faster and easier to use. It's going to take some time to implement, but we'll get there, and I'm really excited to see where we can take things from here.